Bueno,
ahí va. Arjuna Vatra, Evam Satata Yukhaye, Bhakta Kupan Sivipasate, Echapi Ascharama Vyaktam, Esham Te Yoga Vitamaha.
Easy for me to control this one.
Okay, do you
want
a conversation?
Arjuna inquired, which is considered to be more perfect? Those who are properly engaged in your devotional service, or those who worship the impersonal Brahman, the unmanifested? Purport. Krishna has now explained about the personal, the impersonal, and the universal, and has described all kinds of devotees and yogis. Generally, the transcendentalists can be divided into two classes. One is the impersonalist, and the other is the personalist. The personalist devotee engages himself with all energy in the service of the Supreme Lord. The impersonalist engages himself not directly in the service of Krishna, but in meditation on the impersonal Brahman, the unmanifested. We find in this chapter that of the different processes for realization of the Absolute Truth, Bhakti Yoga, devotional service, is the highest. If one at all desires to have the association of the Supreme Personality of Godhead, then he must take to devotional service. Those who worship the Supreme Lord directly by devotional service are called personalists. Those who engage themselves in meditation on the impersonal Brahman are called impersonalists. Arjuna is here questioning which position is better. There are different ways to realize the Absolute Truth, but Krishna indicates in this chapter that Bhakti Yoga, or devotional service to Him, is the highest of all. It is the most direct, and it is the easiest means for association with the Godhead. In the second chapter, the Lord explains that a living entity is not the material body, but is a spiritual spark, a part of the Absolute Truth. In the seventh chapter, he speaks of the living entity as part and parcel of the Supreme Whole, and recommends that he transfer his attention fully to the whole. In the eighth chapter, it is stated that whoever thinks of Krishna at the moment of death is at once transferred to the spiritual sky, Krishna's abode. And at the end of the sixth chapter, the Lord says that out of all the yogis, he who thinks of Krishna within himself is considered to be the most perfect. So throughout the Gita, personal devotion to Krishna is recommended as the highest form of spiritual realization. Yet there are those who are still attracted to Krishna's impersonal Brahmajyoti effulgence, which is the all-pervasive aspect of the Absolute Truth, and which is unmanifest and beyond the reach of the senses. Arjuna would like to know which of these two types of transcendentalists is more perfect in knowledge. In other words, he is clarifying his own position because he is attached to the personal form of Krishna. He is not attached to the impersonal Brahman. He wants to know whether his position is secure. The impersonal manifestation, either in this material world or in the spiritual world of the Supreme Lord, is a problem for meditation. Actually, one cannot perfectly conceive of the impersonal feature of the Absolute Truth. Therefore, Arjuna wants to say, what is the use of such a waste of time? Arjuna experienced in the 11th chapter that to be attached to the personal form of Krishna is best, because he could thus understand all other forms at the same time, and there was no disturbance to his love for Krishna. This important question asked of Krishna by Arjuna will clarify the distinction between the impersonal and personal conceptions of the Absolute Truth.
So Krishna leaves himself open to be asked any question by Arjuna. So Arjuna is asking, well, sometimes you talk about the impersonal Brahman, sometimes you talk about personal, which is actually better? Because Krishna said, well, in the following verses, he said, but in his opinion, the personal worship is the best. However, if someone follows the intestinal system, eventually they also reach him, but it's very difficult in the early stage. So, which do you want? The direct, easy process or the difficult process?
Easy.
How many went to easy process? How many went to Disney Hall?
He always made that.
That's how he's on air.
I want to be a Hare Krishna.
A natural.
You have to shave on your shave.
I don't need to shave.
So, after a number of days to go from India to New Dwarka, the doctor said you should go by slow, gradual route. So I went to Sri Lanka to, that is just for a few hours. But we managed to visit the temple and the orphanage and to get some program. Then we were in Kuala Lumpur for 4 days, and they had one session of the congregation of the temple all gathered together to discuss how to improve the devotee relationship and many other topics. So I was asked to speak there. Then we went to Hong Kong on the Indian route of Bangkok. We only stayed in Bangkok like 4 hours, but they managed to bring out 20 devotees. Now, usually Bangkok is a very tough place to link devotees, but somehow now they're making a lot of devotees. And so we talked to those devotees, and one of the very influential people who were in the torch of fire on behalf of the nation of Thailand during the recent Olympics in China. He is there. So he brought us to our flight, and he gave us a special send-off. So my life was a very fruitful visit. Finally, we made it to Hong Kong, where we spent 3 nights and 2 days. In Hong Kong, I know our devotees had come from many countries, and because they wanted to see me. So they said, just for 3 days, come to China, and there we'll have some special healer. Heal you in 3 days. Unfortunately, we had already committed to coming to Los Angeles. So, how Dr. Achutananda, our dear doctor here, he told right after LA and the festival in India to definitely consider going to China. he didn't promise anything. He definitely would consider it.
We consider.
He's confirming it.
Diplomatic politician.
You learned to be a politician, you're saying? Anyway. Three days, Arjuna turned on. They said, it's the healing power. Now, well, here, you're right, last night. Actually, we're all a little bit affected by it. Oh, we went, yeah, to Tokyo, we didn't stop. Just changed flight to Hawaii, where we spent how many days?
Two and a half days.
And the devotees there gave us a very nice care, very nice attention. So the air there was very rich. So I mentioned that. And they said Prabhupada had said there were vitamins in the Hawaiian air. Well, if you were, we were breathing them in. So finally, we reached last night here in New Dwarka. Had the deities of Darshan and Sanun at that time.
Toshini
was doing arti.
Yeah.
And so nice darshan going to Thai with many Dwarka deeds and Jagannath, Valdeya, Subhadra, and Subhava. So then this afternoon we went to see one of the leading doctors in the world on stroke rehabilitation. And at UCLA. So he's a lot of time to listen to us. And he personally examined me. He said I had the strength, but I lacked the balance, which a number of doctors have said. If you put my strength at a 4 out of 5, which is something, he said maybe he can get some shortcuts, but I have to force my brain to learn to balance. And he said, normally it's also something automatic that's in the spinal cord. So one way or another, we should learn to balance. He said it's going to be a long road for you. And they had to do therapy for many, many months. So, this was his opinion. He said he could see him again in January after we take 1 month of therapy here. So, see what his opinion will be then. So, now we're here in Dwarka where we're going to take up the personal process of God realization. Only our Ishwara Puri Maharaj does, likes the more difficult way. I know he was playing a joke on us, but joke's on him. We've been following the process of Bhakti Yoga, and in this way, we hope that we'll achieve our success. And I'll be doing a physical therapy.
What happened?
On Monday we attend a clinic here called High Hope. And then we use the therapist also recommended by ICU, ICI. We will discuss it then tomorrow or next day. So, like this, I'll be recording. Tomorrow is the disappearance day of Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur as I asked to give a Bhagavatam class. What is the screen of video here? What's the video?
The time.
7:30.
7:30. Good morning.
What's
the
video? The website that they
gave. The website.
Oh, LA.
LA Live.
LA Live.
LA Live.
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 US.
Dot.
US.
US.
But it's live, no life.
Live.
Live. Dot US.
You got that? L-I-V-E, L-A, live. I found this channel to be alive. I would be getting a class in the temple, but most of the devotees went on the Harinam. So I'm getting class here. This is the new quarters. We have our nice quarters in the kitchen and the room for the secretaries and dining table. All the amenities necessary. Even the bathroom.
Very big bathroom.
Slavas Rudra, the temple president, came and he said, "You're welcome here." I said, any causing you some disturbance? No, no. We would like you to be here. In fact, if you want, you can stay here permanently.
We will. I recorded.
So, everyone tells me Shin Charlie to stay here.
Yes.
This is it,
definitely. But I'm only traveling now from one therapy to the next for a seasonal doctor or something. Occasionally.
They can come and see you here.
Yeah, so I'll be here for probably 2 months. If you want to see me, then the temple manager, Baba Kita Das, he invites you, come here. And I heard that Sunday, Radha Swami is coming, and already Prada Maharaj is here.
Yes.
And your Rahu Prabhu is here, so come and join the party. And there's really a wedding.
Very soon.
Very soon.
Next weekend.
Really?
Yeah.
Yeah, before the 15th.
Yeah,
we're gonna say before the 15th. Yeah. Oh, check the calendar.
The
Nakshatra. Anyone know when post-mosh begins? I told them that you have before or after post. Because the Tosh is not a good month for weddings, in India at least. So it's sometime in mid-November, so mid-December, so mid-January. So I heard that January 16th was the Pongal. So it's Pongal, usually the December 16th should be the beginning of the Tosh Mass. It's the last month in the year. I usually would attend the Rath Yatra in Chennai, Coimbatore. So they have the Rath Yatra either on the last day of the year or the first day of the New Year. Where their New Year is a Makara Sankranti. The last day is called Bogi, where you learn something old in the house. As like a symbolic getting into the old, learning the old, letting in the new. So anyway, it's where we left. We came, we went to tonight. We also had a very nice program there and a nice situation there. We tried out some of the machines that just got new. Anybody watching the internet?
Yeah, 9 people.
Can you tell where they come from?
We should put on the website that we'll give a class for our work.
Yeah, done.
3 hours later in the other side.
Any questions? The internet can also ask a question. They said they would supply a loudspeaker to me, but the loudspeaker was taken high enough. So, I was present in my floor. Why not? Ashila Prabhupada was speaking on the occasion of the disappearance of Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur. And so I'll speak on that and other things tomorrow. So, any questions?
If Krishna says that the impersonalist way is more difficult than personal, so
louder.
Why Krishna is giving that way?
Why is Krishna giving the personal and the impersonal way?
No, he said, because if impersonal is more difficult, why is Krishna giving that? Okay. An option.
If you go to Los Angeles, you go to New York, non-stop flight, either in 4 hours. Or you can go by train. How many days can you go by bus? Also takes many days. Or you can drive. Or like our Bhakti Maharaj, you can walk. So why does the government offer these options? Why they don't just put everybody on a plane and watch them go and find it? You see, it's a free world. You can do what you want. If someone wants to take it the difficult way, Krishna, that's it. Some people, they are inimical to the personal way. They are like, they don't like it. They don't like Krishna. They don't go out of their way to offend Krishna, but they. Then they like the personal way. So Krishna gives them some way that they can reach him eventually. go round and round on things. After many, many births, we realize that Krishna is everything, and we reach Krishna. So that's really his mercy, because it's their foolishness that they take the difficult path. Why don't they take the simple path? But he gives an option to everyone that they can take whichever way they want. I was one time trying to make a life as a devotee. He was really into the impersonal truth. He would go naked almost in his closet and sit on deer skin, chant, "Om Shanti, Shanti, Shanti." Oh, and he'd be going chanting. I tried to tell him, chant Hare Krishna. He said, "Okay, well, I first have to chant my own." I said, "Okay, later you can chant Hare Krishna." "No, well, I'm not finished my own yet, so." And I showed him in the 14th chapter, last verse, it says, Krishna says, "Ramanam, Patishahav, I am the basis. I am the support for the impersonal Ramana." He looked at it. "What? What? No! My whole life I've been worshiping the impersonal truth as the origin of the races. So here, no, no, I'll see you tomorrow." He was really, really upset. Next day I went to see him. He was smiling, happy. I said, "No, what happened?" I called one of the professors at the University of Assam, a professor of Sanskrit, and I asked him, "What is Brahmana Vatishtaham mean?" "Oh, that means Krishna, the basis of the four-headed Brahma." Krishna, her part, specifically said, doesn't mean that. Anyway, I realized this guy's a tough nut. If I get too heavy with him, he's going to cry out. So the Prabhupada said, if you get someone who's like a diehard, impersonal, literature, engaging in devotional service, don't talk philosophy. So after that, I didn't talk any more philosophy to him. But I let him engage in devotional service. After some years, he came to me and said, "You know, Maharaj, I'm starting to understand about the personal truth. I believe in the personality of life." So, eventually, if they're not nil and nimly called to Krishna, they can come to the right path. Eventually, it's, there are some people, that's what they want to believe, so. Hare Krishna. Are the devotees healthy?
By your mercy, Maharaj. Maharaj, I have a next question. And sometimes when I want to understand Krishna more personally, and I realize that
you
all the time.
You understand, Maharaj.
Krishna, I try to understand Krishna more personally, but in my experience, it's not possible without a spiritual master and without devotee's mercy. It's it's not possible by my, if I won't force this process, it's not work. But when I can see you, I can listen to you, I can see the devotees and then it's work. Otherwise, it's like today also when I see you, Guru Maharaj, on the temple, and I feel that deity is more personal with you in that time.
Yeah.
Thank you very much.
Did you hear what she said?
From
Ishwarapuri.
Talking
to you. Mm-hmm. Que si oyó
lo que ella dijo.
You heard what she said?
Yeah. I'm listening, but I'm reading also. Some letters.
Oh.
He's saying choosing our way.
He's choosing the heart.
It's important, but I have to listen.
Welcome.
You crush it, huh? No, I send a letter for you, Guru Maharaj. You want it? You have to let it, I have it.
Who has a mic hooked up?
Mic.
Mm-hmm. Who has a mic
hooked
up? Broadcasting has been done by from here.
So you heard it, you said?
Yeah, I hear also, but I didn't pay attention, but it's clearly. Yeah, the sound in there.
All those on the internet, did you hear what she said? Do you understand?
Yes.
Good?
Yes. Nobody's replying.
You see. What I mean, when you actually show, you keep the picture of our guru on the plate, and we show the picture to guru, the guru, and offer deities. As we're offering to all the deities, then we offer to the guru, and offer to the guru. If we're taking that, we're offering to the Guru Parampara, to Krishna. And Krishna, we're first offer to Krishna, Guranga, to Jagannath, and then we offer down to the six Goswamis, Guru Parampara, and finally down to Krishna, unto our Guru. Ideally, we should think Guru is always there. He's offering my worship through the Guru. The Guru is present. But in some cases, some of them offer through their Siksha Guru, or some of them offer to Prabhupada because the Guru is not present. In honor of Sri Guru.
It's got in the song.
So thank you. Your realization is not wrong. Correct. That we should think. How we're offering our worship through the Guru, he offers to his Guru, he offers to that. That way you will feel more connected to Krishna. Any other question? What's your name?
Jai Gauranga Das.
Jai Gauranga Das ki.
Jai.
Jai Vatakamaraj ki Jai. So in this connection, I was wondering, one time I asked my guru, Radha Swami, how do we feel the same inspiration that we feel when you're with us, when you're not with us? And it was a big issue. And he just, in humility, he said, I don't know how you feel inspired when I am with you. Mm-hmm. And that was the end of the conversation. So I was wondering when Mataji was saying she, when you came in the temple, that she felt Krishna's presence more, the deity more personally. So I was wondering, how can we feel the guru's presence or get the inspiration from the Vani in the same way, like now we're with you, we feel our consciousness is raised automatically.
Initially, we see the guru, when you see the guru, and the guru is present, that's called Vapu Seva. So that brings its kind of information. But sometimes, even the guru is present, we might not, like this is the first day, so she's coming, at it here for them. 1 month, 6 weeks, 8 weeks. We hope she'll still feel the same way. But otherwise, you sometimes, the audience start to take the guru for granted, and they start thinking other things. Even the guru is present, the mind may go off. So if we are thinking, if we're actually in separation of the guru, then that is not exactly the same, but it can be more intense because we're thinking of Krishna as we're thinking of guru, that he's a present through his body. And we, at the same time, we feel separation, we feel some connection. In that moment, it's very difficult to forget the guru. Now, to actually achieve that separation of the guru is absent. That's like a high stage. I was watching a video once of a Prabhupada leaving, so I see getting on the ethic, lost his way. Crying, fellows leaving, but one devotee was chanting Krishna, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, he had jumped from the camera, smiling. I was with the Hari Sri or someone, and he said, when Prabhupada saw that, he said, this devotee is not advanced story. Because the guru is leaving and everybody is all in separation. He's like a calm ecstasy, you know. But the guru, you know. So a mature devotee would feel the guru is leaving, you feel something. So it's a question of maturity of your devotional service. If you're feeling separation, you cannot forget the guru. If you're actually feeling, but to reach that stage, it's not, you know, that's also like some advancement. So.
Thank you. I'm happy I got to ask the question, because when I first met you here in New Dwarka, Bhagavad Kripa introduced me, and I was getting ready for book distribution. I was standing next to you, and you said, so, do you have any questions? And I was so nervous, and I was just, oh, Maharaj. And he looked at me and said, you should always have a question. Maybe 10 years ago.
I heard Radha Swami coming on Sunday.
Next Sunday.
The 13th.
Yeah. Is that Sunday?
Next Sunday.
Yeah, a week from this Sunday.
It's false Sunday.
So we're also looking for a sound at the yatra in the marathon. I officially welcome everyone. And he had me give class on Chaitanya, childhood, the past time with him. He could always hear our demo.
Nice.
So then, apparently when I felt sick last year, at the, on November, say, October, November, he had his yatra praying for me. And he also sent doctors to watch over me while I was at the Hinduja hospital. It was not the easiest thing for the doctors to be at another hospital because the doctors are normally treated with great respect while you're a doctor today. A nurse to stand up, but there's one particularly, I don't know, like a really late nurse. She'd tell off the others occasionally. Remember, you don't have to listen to these doctors. They're not our doctors. They belong to another hospital. So they would chase up their doctor, who is in charge of the ICU, and to make some time to see that I got something I needed. And he would like, he gave them a hard time. But they're doing all this on the will of the Radha Swami. So, this year when I went, he said that you all prayed last year, this is the person, so Krishna heard our prayer, he's still with us. Today the doctor's at 50% plus. Patients who get this type of a stroke, hemorrhage of the pump, then they die. So he said, in India, there are some doctors that are serving for 15, 20 years, a neurologist. They said they never saw anybody survive. If somebody survived, they were like vegetables. So they call me a miracle case.
Jai
Brahma again. So Radha Swami this year, he said, well, you all to pray that by next year you can come and join a yatra dancing.
We saw you dancing with Radha Swami in the Panihati.
Yeah, we saw that.
I was ecstatic.
Wow.
Kind of. Support. By the way, the physical impediments can't stop the ecstasy.
Evil.
Yeah. Tomorrow there is a Bhagavatam class, so better to take early rest.
Yeah.
Are you the last question? Any internet question?
Going up.
So, is there anything I should watch for another 5 minutes or close it right here?
Close.
Any last question here?
Are you
raise your hand?
No, I was saying.
You raise your hand, I saw it.
There you go.
Any last question? So she did. Triple hitter.
I don't know. I'm sorry, I don't know English well. I will try.
Yes, you're doing pretty good.
So many times as you tolerate many mistakes of disciple or some other devotees, but in last year I realized that I cannot tolerate many things, but I love devotees and I want to learn how to be more humble, but it's supposed to be so difficult. And I want to ask why it's so difficult to be very humble. I want to cooperate with all devotees and be like Lord Chaitanya said that we cannot chant it properly, Hare Krishna Maha Mantra, if we are not humble. Like, we are not following for his instruction to not be But it's most difficult for me right now, as I realize, be humble. And my question, how we can be humble? How I can be humble?
Yes, it's a long question. It's all very short, but it's very long.
It's
very hot. Is that the Kazakhstan nature? So, when I was a new devotee, I was told. I forget who told me, someone gave me advice, saying it was from Prabhupada, that you should see the good and bad of the devotees, and you have to follow the good, and you discriminate what is not good, and you don't want to follow that. Some devotees have pronounced good, but they may do something weird. Some have pronounced bad, but they may do something good. So accordingly, you just take it. And you don't like categorize anyone, all of the good or all bad. You just follow the good and avoid the bad. So, I found like that. It was easy to practice Krishna consciousness, and I didn't have to worry about whether a devotee was good or bad. They just did some things which were good, some things which were bad. Some things that I wanted to follow, and I liked their enthusiasm, but I didn't like the way they criticized others. So I avoided criticizing, but I try to take out that vision. So I like it if there's someone doing to us, if we want to advise them, well, we can, but then we should also discriminate. How will we tell them? Will they take it? If they're senior vice chancellor, is that our or senior the leader. It's not our position to correct them. But we could ask them a question. Like in India, sometimes the devotees would come in. Maharaj, can I ask you a question? I mean, you don't take any offense to ask you a question. Do I have the permission to ask you a question, Maharaj? third or fourth time they ask him. No, something's up. Yeah, okay. And then they express whatever the doubt is about something you did. So that's what you really, I mean, even if you take offense, they're not at fault. It's the right of the teacher to always ask the senior any question. You're right to ask the guru the question. Yes. His duty is to the acharya is to represent the previous acharya by his example. So yeah, Sindhya Vaishnava is supposed to be a standard. So if you ask the question that you do this thing, and sometimes I wonder whether I should also come here as I look to you as a very senior Vaishnava. So, it's unlikely they'll take offense. If they take offense, you technically didn't do anything wrong. So, the offense is not there for them. So, in this way, one can be humble, at the same time be assertive. So, the eventually, if you want to leave friends, then Lord Chaitanya said, Alanina, Alanina, don't expect any praise for yourself, offer all appreciation to others. So if you offer your appreciation to others, you'll find a lot of people like you. Everybody likes to be appreciated. You don't have to say the aspect that you don't like, unless it's really bothering you. You can just say the part that you want to evolve. So usually there's something we like about almost everybody. So in this way, if you have it all, their tendency will be to act in such a way that they reinforce the good appreciation they got. And other things are not even get left aside.
Thank you.
Thank all of you.
Thank you for watching our videos. Be sure to subscribe to our channel. We publish new videos every day, and don't forget to like and share our channel.